All right, 920. This is Gene. My name is Bromley. This is week one of our Lindy 3 class here at the 920 Special. All right, so we worked on our basic swing out and really our spacing because our foundation is really important to any fancy move, and this week and series is fancy moves. So what the idea here, and I'm going to face the camera here with Gene out of the way, with Gene in front of me, but I've got my feet offset here, so my left foot is open, and if you were to kind of chart it, it goes my left foot, Gene's right foot, my right foot, Gene's left foot. And on my rock step, I get out of the way, so I've got one, two, and now you can see my hips got a free line so that Gene can travel without worrying about the leader being in the way. Then we cut across on three and four, three, four. Goal there is to turn at the same time. Notice my left leg now has the outside lane over here, so that I can send Gene right by me, five, and then I step across the lane again, six, getting back to my starting position, seven and eight, and you'll notice again I'm offset. So we did a drill where we actually broke our swing out down into two beat increments with a two beat hold in between, really focusing on being in the moment versus falling ahead or rushing ahead. So that looked like this, a five, six, seven, and a one, two, one, two, one, a two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, a two. And then we took that drill once we really had good control and kept our feet underneath us as long, and as well we're getting out of our follow's way and turning together, and we just add our swing out right after. So we had a one, two, one, two, one, and two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, and two, and one, two, three, five, seven. So I still travel along that same path, and Gene travels in and out. And I'm gonna show you real quick, just in that starting position. One, two, one, two, one, and two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, and two.
A couple of things to note for the follows. We really talked about rotating when our partner comes towards us. Mm-hmm. So we want shoulders, hips, and feet, everything mm-hmm. to move together. So as we go one, two, one, two, a one, a two, everything moves in line.
And you'll notice Jean's on balance, so she's not falling forward because her feet are behind her,
right,
or back.
I'm also not traveling too far back because what my leader's doing is he's slowing me down and stopping me from continuing. So we're going one, two, one, two, one, two. So I basically just pivot where my right foot is. And then I finish five. For the swing outs we were doing today, which was the sending your partner sideways, we cross behind, six, and then seven, eight. Again, you could do a swivel or you can change whatever you need to in your one, two, but those are the main points for us as well.
Yeah. So then we added a move where we utilized the follow's connection with that arm down. And we had a little bit of a wind up here, then I spun Gene, then I just kind of walked around and then finished the swing out. So that all the way through, kind of walking through it, a one, two, three, five, six, seven, and dot, D, dot, da, D. And I mentioned you can count it, it's technically a
12 count move,
if, 14 count, one, two, three, and five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Oh, Gene was right, 12 counts.
Always.
But I don't count very often because I really focus on scatting the rhythm. So in my head, it's going dot, D, dot, da, D, da, da, D, da, da, D, da, da, D, da, da, D. And to me, that just really allows me to change things up in the moment to fit better with the music because the music's kicking out rhythms. And it's not, except for 8, 9, and 10, counting usually. Slim and Slam song. So a couple things that you can do with that. Da, di, da, da, di, da, da, di, da, di, da, da, di, da, da, di, da, da, di. Or you could add any of your sort of second half of a swing out moves, like a Texas Tommy, to the end of that. So you guys were great. Thank you so much. We'll see you next week.